Today we're going to experiment with bubbles. This is what we need. Glycerin, dish soap, water, sugar, shallow plate, measuring utensils, and gloves. Let's make some bubbles. Glycerin bubbles. 2 cups of water. 1/4 cup soap. 2 tablespoons glycerin. These are glycerin bubbles. Sugar bubbles. 1 cup water. 1 tablespoon glycerin sugar. 2 tablespoons dish soap. Sugar bubbles. Glycerin and sugar bubbles. 1 cup water. 2 tablespoons dish soap. 1 tablespoon glycerin. 1 tablespoon sugar. This is sugar and glycerin. Glycerin and sugar. How does it work? Bubbles consist of a thin liquid film. The secret of making strong bubbles is surface tension. So what is surface tension?
Surface tension, the elastic-like force existing in the surface of a body, especially a liquid, tending to minimize the area of the surface caused by asymmetries and the intermolecular forces between surface molecules.
Basically, the top layer of water's ability to allow items to float, even if they are heavier than the water.
Surface tension is a bond that holds water molecules together.
We are water molecules.
What are you?
Water.
What are you doing?
We are bonding.
Not that kind of bonding. This kind of bonding.
We're demonstrating surface tension. The paperclip and pepper can float on the surface of the water because many water molecules hold tightly together.
I am soap.
We're going to weaken the water molecules with the soap.
When the soap hits the water, it breaks the water molecules apart. The pepper runs away from the soap because the soap fills space between the water molecules. Surface tension of water is combined with soap, it becomes elastic. This is what makes bubbles possible. Glycerin and sugar are sticky. They help hold the soap to the water molecules.